Hello YouTube, my name is Sebastian and welcome to yet again another YouTube video. So this time we're going to be checking out Amen by Bring Me the Horizon. I'm a pretty big fan of their work. I previously posted a reaction to Lost, which I thought was quite a fun, catchy little song. Liked the kind of electronic effects and the kind of mixing on it. It's really, really good. So for this song, I'm expecting something a bit more like Lost, or maybe like Strangers, as this kind of seems to be the direction that they've been heading in for the last few songs. So just looking at the title, Amen, I'm expecting themes of religion. More interestingly though, there's quite a few features on the song. I was quite shocked to see that, they've got a Lil Uzi Vert as a collaborator, but they've also got Daryl Palumbo and Glassjaw. So Lil Uzi Vert is best known for his song XO Tour Life, and that's how I know him. Although I've never heard of Daryl Palumbo or Glassjaw though, so let me know if you guys know these bands and think they're any good or artists, and put some songs in the comments if there's anything that stands out that you think we should react to. Anyway, without further ado, let's listen to Amen.
I hope you have fun.
Wow. Okay, so that completely diverted what I said about it being more like Lost and something like Strangers. They've immediately gone in with extreme anger and rage, and it sounds even heavier than anything they released on like post-human survival horror, in my opinion. It's got less of that kind of like electronic mixing to an effect, and they've just gone in with that kind of angst already. Just to explain these lyrics, I hope you have fun rotting in hell. So obviously hell is kind of a religious idea. If you do something bad, you go to hell. Swim the witch. So back in the days, it was a religious practice to hunt down witches, burn them, drown them, do all kinds of unspeakable things to them, and slay the infidel. Basically, kill people who don't believe what you believe in. Kind of, I guess it's seeing the perspective from kind of like a religious extremist and what they kind of see or think, and the actions they want to take. So there's an effect kind of just behind the burn, burn, burn line. It's like a guitar raising in pitch. So it kind of like, it kind of amplifies the effect of the burn, burn, burn line. Pretty self-explanatory there. But the burn, I'd like to see you burn, 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 really kind of act on the line before saying I hate you. You hate them so much, so you don't want them to just burn. You want them to burn, burn, burn. And they've got that kind of guitar screech just behind it, adding to that effect. Like it. So Ollie's gone into those clean vocals for what I assume here is the chorus. The lyrics are tell all your friends, this is the end of everything. Basically, it's just kind of signaling that in this song, they're about to face the apocalypse. Too late to repent. The wicked will reap what they sow. Yeah, I'm really, really digging those clean vocals. I really, really like the way that he sings the line so. Oh, sorry, he sings the word so. It kind of really extends it and does it kind of melodically. The lines here, just saying, it's too late to repent, too late to say Hail Marys, ask God for forgiveness, the wicked will reap what they sow, those that have sinned, they're going to go to hell, like in the first line. They've they've really switched it up in this part of the chorus. They've gone from just the clean vocals to having clean vocals backed up by the kind of the heavy screams. So we'll sanctify and then rise my brethren is done heavy, purify, purge out the sins done heavy, rejoice in their sorrow and sing. So yeah, basically it's just kind of using religious words like sanctify, purify, rejoice, to kind of further affect this. It's kind of like a reflection of how kind of religious person or like a Jehovah's Witness kind of thing might operate or a preacher might preach. Yeah, awesome. So this next part of the chorus, all hail next gen, all hail next gen, that's repeated. I don't really know what next gen means. I'm guessing it either means generation or Genesis. Generation wouldn't make as much sense because if it's the apocalypse, there shouldn't be anything coming next. Genesis, I guess, maybe would make sense because it's like the formation of something new, going from the world to an apocalypse to a new beginning, kind of life ever after kind of thing, I guess. I don't know. Hail, once again, a religious word, or it can be used in negative connotations. And can I get an amen? That's referring to the title of the song, and I guess this might be the end of the chorus. One thing just to point out that I really, really, really like, the way that Ollie sings amen, he does it clean, and then he ends just the last snippet of the word in this kind of like slight screechy vocal. Really, really nice. Sounds awesome. Body called the exorcist. This is jealousy, the child is possessed. So we've got the first feature of the song. I don't know if this is Glash or Daryl. Not sure. Yeah, somebody called the exorcist. This is heresy. This child is possessed. Exorcisms are typically done to kind of banish demons out from possessed people. It was kind of a big religious practice back in the day. I don't know how common exorcisms are today. And heresy, once again, is just kind of a religious word. Big religious themes in the song. Don't you know? Yes, so six. Yeah, so I like these lines. Subjugate the apostates, to kind of bring under control someone who's renounced their belief, essentially. So that kind of works with the previous heresy line. An apostate might be spreading heresy, so you want to stop them from doing that. And they're kind of like gaslighting them, saying, don't you know you're so sick, sick, sick? So 666 is typical the devil's number. But I like how they've turned that into a question. You're so sick, sick, sick. So you're like kind of like, you're sick with a belief in like the devil or kind of worshipping the devil kind of thing. Yeah, really smart lines here. Awesome. Your fanatics pray on me, hate on me, patiently waiting to watch me bleed. Get your hair from out of my ass, got me feeling like a human centipede. Damn, Lil Uzi Vert enters the track. Yeah, so I really like how he's really switched up the flow of the song. It's gone from being quite slow to this really, really, really kind of fast rap flow kind of thing that Lil Uzi Vert's doing. In terms of the lyrics, it's quite good. So it's kind of switched perspective from someone being like, ah, he's a heretic, you're so sick, sick, sick. And now the person that's being kind of told these things is replying, yeah, you fanatics pray on me, hate on me, patiently waiting to watch me bleed. So get your head from out of my ass, got me feeling like a human centipede. So this kind of constant beration that these religious people are attacking him with, it makes him feel less than human, like a human centipede, kind of like a monstrous creation. Yeah, so this part of the song kind of slows back down. Pretty kind of simple. Just let me breathe, stay the fuck away from me. I don't really want me as my own enemy. So he's telling these kind of religious fanatics to stay away from him, let him just kind of chill, relax. He don't want to target himself as an enemy, this kind of monstrous creation. He's just him. He wants to be himself, not kind of adhere to kind of these religious beliefs that other people are trying to force him into. Yeah, so pretty much the same kind of chorus as before, but this time the last line, "Can I get an amen?" Ends in that kind of more iconic Bring Me style. I think this is going about to go into the bridge, maybe. Not certain, but I'm guessing. That kind of like choppy duh, 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 that it ends with. Yeah, really excited to what I'm about to hear now. Just let me suffer. Just let me breathe. Just let me suffer. Suffer. Just let me. Just let me suffer. Just let me breathe. Sorry for the skips. Had to do it for copyright reasons, but that was a banger breakdown. Nothing too crazy, just some repeated phrases. Just let me suffer. Just let me breathe, etc. Yeah, goes hard nonetheless. I like it. Very catchy. I'm about to lose control. Falling from grace. Falling again. This part of the song has some really, really, really nice scratchy guitar that kind of just scratches the itch in my ear, if you get me. Kind of this heavy vocals sound amazing. I'm about to lose control. Fallen from grace and foul renegade, one line to the next. There's kind of like alliteration with the start. I don't think there's anything too crazy, just saying that he might have sinned or something. He's fallen from grace, his faith has been corrupted now that he's, I guess, seen the way that these religious fanatics are constantly harassing, I guess, maybe his friend. So once again, a kind of repeat of "I'm about to lose control." I guess he's the anger is welling within him, and he's about to, I don't know, do something bad. But saying "you will be done till kingdom come," so he's gonna put you in the dirt until the apocalypse is kind of maybe, I guess, over in a loose sense, and heaven comes and whatever, that kind of thing, and there will be no absolution. You can't be detached from the guilt, etc. So I really, really, really like this part of the chorus. I really like how Sanctify and Purify were just amped up like so much in heaviness. One thing I'm a really, really, really big fan of is when the chorus gets progressively heavier each time. So the kind of best example I can think of that as a song is Bored by Deftones. Every single time he does the lines, I get bored. It just gets like heavier and heavier. And essentially Ollie's kind of done the same thing here, where he's made Sanctify and Purify a lot heavier, but he's only done it on the third chorus, where he says those words in a like a kind of scream. But yeah, I really like that. It sounds awesome. I want to start with saying, really like that kind of, once again, that choppy brah, 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 kind of thing that Bring Me does all the time. It always sounds good. Always sounds good. Yeah, these kind of lines here, pretty simple. I execute judgment on you. So execute is a very strong word. Typically, you know, be executed, beheaded, or executed in different ways. Judgment, so he's kind of passing judgment on you, you wicked demon. So it's kind of funny that it's a person saying this, because religiously, typically, yeah, so the song just ends with saying, "You burn in hell, you burn in hell, it's over for you. That's it, there's nothing else. You're going to be rotting in hell for the rest of time." Yeah, so really, I quite like that song. I think it's nothing special production-wise in terms of what Bring Me the Horizon usually does. It's nothing like Post-Human Survival Horror, where the kind of electronic, amazing production is like up to like this level. I think the kind of production here is maybe up here. But I think the fact that there's so many people featured on this song is quite different to what Bring Me the Horizon usually does. And they each respective artist does their bit really well. As I mentioned before, I really like what Lil Uzi Vert does. His kind of choppy flow, his fast lyrics go really well in the song. I think there might have been one extra artist doing screams, and then there might have been another artist doing kind of that slightly slowed down part of the song. That's how my mind is putting the voices together. Really like the song overall. I'll probably listen to it again. It's really kind of energetic. That's kind of what I really like in a song. So yeah. But if you'd like to see more reactions, please like and subscribe. I'll definitely be uploading more. If there's anything else you picked up on the song, leave it in the comments below. And let me know if there's anything else that you'd like me to react to. Thank you. See you later, guys. It's Sebastian. Bye.